Hello everyone, welcome to All in One PhD. Today our topic is verbs. There are two types of verbs. One is transitive verb and another one is intransitive verb. First, let us look at a verb, transitive verbs. A transitive verb is a verb that requires an object to receive the action. A transitive verb requires an object. Without this object, the action cannot be done. It requires an object to complete their meaning. It even requires an object to complete the meaning of the sentence. Example, I gave him a gift. In this, gift and him. Him and gift are the objects. I borrowed a book. Here, book is object. And an object is a person or thing to or for whom something is done. Transitive verb is divided into direct object and indirect object. A transitive verb can take more than one object. Donov gave his sister a laptop. In this sentence, there is an intransitive or indirect object and a direct object. His sister is indirect object. A laptop is direct object. Intransitive verbs. An intransitive verb does not take any object, which means the intransitive verb does not require any object. Using an object immediately after an intransitive verb will make incorrect sentence. We shouldn't use object after intransitive verb, which will cause the sentence incorrectly. However, there may be other information of the verb, such as one or more preposition phrases or adverbs. Examples. Correct sentence. The students arrived at the residency in Houston. The students arrived Houston. Here, the students arrived. Even though if we didn't keep this, the meaning of the sentence will be same. But here it will be incorrect. The second sentence is incorrect because the verb can't take an object. Because the verb cannot take an object. Let us look at few more examples. Some other examples of intransitive verb were vote, sit, increase, love, ordinate, flocation, trend. The patient held determined quickly. Ahmed voted in the local election. May I see here? Attendance increased at the weekly student session as final drew near. Sushant laughed. Here, Ahmed voted. Let us look at this sentence. Ahmed voted also gives the sentence meaning. Even though we keep in the local elections. Here, even though we keep at the weekly study sessions, the meaning will be same. An intransitive note. An intransitive verb can take more than one prepositional phrase or adverb. The patient held determined quickly during the night. Ahmed voted for the incumbent in local elections. There are verbs that are both transitive and intransitive. Some verbs can be transitive and intransitive. Depending some instances. Such a verb may require an object while it other requires an object. Example, format reminder, verb, object, prepositional, adverb, continue, play. These will come with both transitive and intransitive verbs. Three of the students play the guitar. This is transitive. The students will play outside today. intransitive. Here play is coming in transitive verb. Here play is coming in even intransitive verb. Here continue. We will continue the meaning after the break. The meeting continued after the break. Here continue came from transitive verb. Here continue came for even intransitive verb. Let us look at some verbs. Return. Javed returned the book to the library. The student returned to school after the winter break. Here returned, returned. Return came to both transitive and intransitive. Grow. I grow Suchi in my garden. Transitive. My daughter is growing quickly. Here grow. Both came in transitive and intransitive verb. There are some verb patterns. Verb plus ing to infinity, and there are still more. Verb plus ing is also known as gerund. Of this, gerunds are used after certain verbs like I enjoyed singing. Here verb is singing. Here the verb is sing plus ing, so that's singing. So gerunds are used after certain verbs. After they are also used after prepositions. I drank a cup of coffee before leaving. Here leave is preposition ing plus ing, which gives gerund. As the subject or object of the sentence, this is used as subject or the object of the sentence. Swimming is a good exercise. Next one is to infinity. It is used after certain verbs like gerunds. We decided to leave. Here to leave. After many adjectives. It is used after many adjectives. It's difficult to get up early. This as the object or subject of the sentence. This to infinity is even acted as object of the subject as a sentence. I came to London to study. Other types. We can use barely infinity. This is an other type of verb pattern. In this, the infinity is used without to. After the modals, I can meet you at the 6 o'clock. After let, make, and something help. The teacher let us leave early. After some verbs of perceptions. See, watch, hear, notice, feel, sense. I watched her walk away. After expressions with why. Why go out at the night before an exam? This is an example for to infinitive, bare infinitive. Help me to open the gate. Help me open the gate. Another type is verb plus preposition plus ing. Here verb plus preposition plus ing. When the verb prepositions in, at, with, of, for, about, and so on are used before a verb, the verb must be using ing. Let us look at some other examples using preposition plus ing. I am scared of swimming in a sea. Yes, we are swimming. Preposition of. Thanks for giving me a ride. My brother good at playing tennis. However, taking the bus, I am not interested in reading books. Next topic is reflexive pronoun. When the direct object of a transitive verb is same as the subject of the verb is called as reflexive verb. Here, it tells that the direct object of a transitive verb is same as the subject of the verb. Then the verb is called reflexive verb. Joseph gifted himself a bicycle on his birthday. Here we are mentioning, here Joseph is the direct object, subject. Himself is the direct object. Here it is referring to himself or him. Here the new girl introduced herself to the class, which means the new girl introduced about herself. I am preparing myself for the Olympic year. There are some words which uses which can be reflective or non-reflective. I washed my hands. Here, I washed my hands means the person who is telling washed his hands. But in this sentence, the person who is telling washed the dog, so that it is changed. Dog. Here, direct object is dog and subject is I. She is dressing herself, which means she is dressing by her own. And here she is dressing her son. In this sentence, she is dressing her own son. Here, direct object is son and subject is she. Thanks for watching. If you like my explanation, like, share, and for regular updates, subscribe my channel. Thank you.